Next into the tank is a solution for messy little eaters.
Hi, my name's Lindsay Lorraine and I'm from Parker, Colorado. I am the founder of Easy Peasy, and today I am seeking $1 million for a 5% stake in my company.
Wow.
Dang. Hear me out.
Thanks for coming.
You're welcome. Sharks, who has recently had or witnessed mealtime with a toddler? In our case, three toddlers. Let's take a look at what mealtime used to look like at our house.
Oh, your kids are slobs.
Honestly, that was what mealtime used to look like at our house. It was crazy. My husband and I knew there had to be a better way, so we created it. The Happy Mat is an all-in-one silicone placemat and plate. But the best part is the mat suctions to the surface. So this means no more tipples or plates during mealtime.
Clever.
The Happy Mat name really says it all. The smiley face design creates a positive feeding experience. There is truly nothing like Easy Peasy on the market. We are revolutionizing the feeding industry throughout the world. Let's take a look at what mealtime looks like now.
Are these the same kids?
Yeah, they're very good.
I love Easy Peasy.
Oh, come you on, you paid them to say that.
Lindsay, we got to go right to the sales.
Got to go right to the numbers.
Yeah. No, samples.
No, come on.
Samples.
20 million.
Okay.
Is there food in the samples?
Yes. As I said.
The bottom one is Lori's?
Yep, gray is Lori.
There you go, Lori.
and as I said, you can stack and serve everybody at the same time.
It's so cute.
Oh, it's very cute.
And the smiley face design.
How nice is that?
Really does create a positive feeding experience. Blue.
What's the little eyeball in there?
I'm just curious what you sell one mat for.
So one mat retails for $24.99. Our wholesale price is $12.50, and then we have a 50% margin with that.
So you make it for about $6?
Yes, a little bit around that.
So, Lindsay, you've imputed a value, $1,005,000, so you're telling me this business is worth $20 million.
Let's go to the numbers now.
So I think that's the only thing we got to talk about, because that is such a crazy ask unless you have phenomenal sales.
Okay, so yes, our sales are very strong.
Tell us what they are.
I'll be honest, I wanted to do 5 times that valuation.
5 times?
Out with it. What, this in this calendar year, what are you going to sell?
So we've done 85,000 units this year at 1.2 million gross sales.
That's it?
Yep. So
I'm going to pay 16 times sales for a rubber mat with a face on it?
Are you expecting to do 30 this year or something?
Yeah, way more than 30. So last week, we were in Germany at the world's largest baby show. We met with 400 international distributors. We were the hit of the show. So we've gotten 400 contacts, every country, Australia.
Do you take orders?
Yeah, so we sold not on the spot. I mean, Australia said they'll take a container. They would do a 40-foot container every month.
Do you have a patent?
We have 5 long IP portfolio. So we filed a utility patent.
Filed.
We have a design patent. So we're patent pending.
Your patent pending.
So let's assume you're successful and you achieve full patent.
Yeah, we have to assume you're going to get patent.
Let's assume that.
And
it doesn't mean that somebody...
You shouldn't assume that?
No.
No.
You shouldn't assume that.
But let's say, I'm trying to be the upside case. I am actually trying to figure out how it's possible under any scenario on this planet Earth that this business today is worth $20 million.
Well, how much money did you make on the $1.2 million in sales?
So we've netted approximately 14%.
You made $140,000. That was your earnings.
Yeah.
How do you get to $20
million? So we did literally 5 years. I did net present value, 4 times earnings with a 45% discount.
Just so I'm clear, you took what you think you're going to earn in the next 5 years, totaled that up, and got to $20 million today?
Yes. Well...
Do you see a problem in that?
I honestly don't, because there's so much opportunity. I'll be honest, so when we were in Germany last week, I met with 4 different CEOs from massive companies, and two have since sent messages about acquiring us.
Then why are you here, though?
I'll explain. So there's a few different reasons.
I'm trying to be kind before I absolutely eviscerate you. I'm holding back.
Oh my gosh, be nice. I can explain. So I'm here for, so the baby market, we're actually doing phenomenal. We're in Nordstrom. We're sold on Amazon. Bye Bye Baby.
Are you in all Bye Bye Baby stores?
So we are waiting to enter Bye Bye Baby.
Either so you're not in Bye Bye Baby?
Nope, but we met with them, and then we're in about 200 boutiques throughout the country. Our valuation has, in 5 years, will be at 2,000 stores.
No, but hang on.
But
Lindsay,
how many do you sell in each boutique?
So the valuation is, on average, we have 500 mats per year per boutique.
So next year, the best case is $5 million in sales, you think?
I personally think we'll do $10 million in sales next year.
So from all this, you've created 1.2 million in sales. You're going to make 140,000 before you pay yourself. You're optimistic that next year's 10 million, right?
Yep.
After that,
when you look at Australia, this is one example of hundreds of countries we met. You know, a container is $50,000 order. They said they would be ordering a container.
Ooh, who every
month.
Said that?
Oh, distributors.
Did they give you an order?
Yeah.
You don't even know if it's sold through.
Yes.
You haven't even shipped the first order straight. I love the optimism.
Yeah.
But you don't have any data. You come in here asking for a $20 million valuation. You know we're going to be skeptical.
Yep.
You know you're going to have some data. Stop telling me Australia is going to take so many containers.
But that's one. So we're in Canada, we're in South Korea,
You're all over the map. I like to build a solid business on a solid foundation. When you ask for $20 million, you better have solid data, not a story. I'm out.
To me, it's like Sharkonomics 101. If you come in with too high a valuation, you've got a problem.
Yep.
And, you know, the enthusiasm for it, I get it, but I see a huge concern with the patent, a huge concern with it being very early on. And so, for that reason, I'm out.
Thank you for your time.
The way I look at it is the risk is all on me as the investor. I try and translate your optimism and your IP, which hasn't cleared yet. All of these things are unknowns. On the other hand, $1 million is a lot for 5%. So here's a deal that I'll make you. I'll give you the $1 million for 5%. If you don't hit 10 million next year in sales, I get 20%.
You're throwing all the risk back on her.
Sharks are out. Kevin has made a creative offer in order to insure against Lindsay's optimistic sales projections.
So here's a deal that I'll make you. I'll give you the $1 million for 5%. If you don't hit 10 million next year in sales, I get 20%.
You're throwing all the risk back on her.
Because I think the business today is worth $5 million if your patent clears. Because I don't know how to value this business.
I appreciate. I'm humbled.
But you told me you're very optimistic, so I got to buy into it, right?
I mean, if you could go and see the response. I mean, we were at the World Cup.
Lindsay, don't go there. Don't go there.
You're talking in circles now.
Mark, what are you doing?
I'm not going to do a deal with you no matter what, because I would go nuts.
What disturbs me is you're giving us a price today on what the business will be worth 4 or 5 years out. But I'll give you the $1 million, but I want to pay it over 4 years, $250 a year.
Okay.
Restrictions. And you're happy with the 5%?
Yes, I am happy with the 5% because I totally believe in her. I think you have got a runaway product, but I think you're your own worst enemy because of your optimism. I think you need a heavyweight, seasoned person who has built businesses.
Yeah.
The last thing I'm going to do is throw $1 million at you. I think what I have to work into the deal are two contingencies. I think one, I have to know that you get the patent. Secondly, I think we have to establish the benchmarks you cited. I'm happy to pay out the money over 4 years. Over the 4 years, you hit those targets.
And so I appreciate that offer. And I'd love to ask you guys, so Mr. Wonderful, what is your vision if you're going to be involved in the company? What do you see that you would do for the product?
My concerns are this. I'm going to help you with the legals, assuming this patent actually gets issued, because this is going to get knocked off and I will protect it. Number two, I will make this famous online. There's no question about that. I don't think you've really maximized that. So my focus in the short term would be to actually work hard that you did hit the 10 and I only stayed at 5. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'd rather you made it because I think the chance of this being acquired is high.
And I'm thinking about changing my offer as I'm sitting here. I have to be honest.
Yeah, you are.
See, this is what happens,
today.
Lindsay. You had two offers. You're letting him go.
Well, no. And I honestly...
Make a decision. Stop selling.
Okay. I think the decision is I think I'm going to move on.
You're turning down the offers?
You're turning down both offers.
Yeah. I honestly I'm more just... I'm more sad the way this was portrayed because our sales are strong. We have all those relationships, and I feel...
But, Lindsay, he gave you what you were asking for. He gave you the $1 million for the same equity based on what you said, the words that came out of your mouth.
Absolutely, but it's based on contingencies of selling.
But there should
be no risk there. That should be a slam dunk.
Why did you say it
if you didn't mean it?
I want to draw a parallel between you and I because I was in your shoes with wild enthusiasm, wanting to be the queen of New York real estate when I was 22 years old.
Yep.
What was so important in my journey to make it wasn't my optimism, which I had in spades, but it was the self-doubt and the insecurity that I felt all along the way that made me pause and think, oh my God, I better be careful. Can I do it? How will I make it? Who do I use? Who do I trust? My judgment card built my business. You're a wild-ass, enthusiastic entrepreneur, very capable, you've got a great product. All that's fine, but you're missing the self-doubt card.
Yeah, well said, Barbara.
Okay. I'm sorry. Like I said, culturally, I'm trying to build a company that is the right fit for everybody, so I'm thinking maybe this isn't the right fit, so I will pass.
Good luck to you, Lindsay.
Good luck, Lindsay.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
I'm glad that we didn't do a deal because it didn't feel right. So if I would change anything, it would be... I don't even know if I would change anything because I believe that's the right valuation.
Barbara, I think that was the best advice you've ever given. Mm-hmm. She's wildly optimistic.
Yep. Mm.
But great entrepreneurs live in paranoia.
She's just blinded by the light.